Good morning. Welcome to Plateau United Methodist Church. What's turning out to be a beautiful, sunshiny autumn day. And I'm glad that you're here as we gather together once again to worship our living God, Jesus the Christ. So good morning, one and all, especially any who may be visiting. I'd like to call your attention to the announcements. Choir practice is at 5 o'clock today, Christmas play practice during Sunday school. Our network service is today at 6 o'clock. This is our charge conference. In conjunction with that, there'll be a very short board meeting following this morning's worship service. Corner table, the 28th, trunk or treats at Wesley Chapel. Again, let me remind you that they've invited all of you to come, participate, or just to come over to the decoration. Some of these folks go all out to decorate their cars and trucks. The Wesley Chapel Bazaar is the 2nd. UMW meeting is the 4th. The Thanksgiving meal and service is at Wesley. Candy needed for the Cat Square Parade. The flowers on the altar are by the Edith Holland family in memory of Todd and in honor of Susanna and Carly's birthday. I know, say Mike, I think you said you wanted to have the floor. All right. Audrey Locelle, whoever.
I just have a short announcement. The college ministry care packages are on the front pew, so college students, just be aware your church loves you and supports you. And if you want to pick up one for a family member, they're up on the front row. They have cards in them with your name on them.
I'm sorry, David. I hate to do that to you.
Good morning.
I just want to talk a little bit about Heart Square. And first thing I want to do is thank all of you that had anything to do with it, whether you donated some money like some of you did. All the drinks, we had a good group of drinks that came in this year, a whole big pile of desserts. Wonderful desserts. They sold out. They always do. Thank you. Amen. I only ate one piece of cake, so I held off a little bit. Diabetic here. But anyway, we had a great day today. God is good, yesterday, and Jesus gave us a beautiful day. Had sunshine, it was warm, didn't rain on us even after we set up. Last Saturday or before we topped that barbecue, I made the mistake of asking somebody to check the weather for this coming weekend. Wish I hadn't done that. It said Friday rain, Saturday rain, Sunday rain, Monday rain. So I'm the Plateau Warrior. I do that so you don't have to worry, okay? I got you covered. But anyway, we had a great day. We had our workers were fantastic. As usual, we have got that thing down to a well-oiled machine. I'm telling you, if you hadn't been out there before, you ought to really go watch these people work. It takes a minimum of 36 people to do the job. And we normally go out and we rent a tent, $350 for a 20 by 30 tent with a high rise. And we have 2 to 3 church tents we set up out there. One for condiments, we have 3 condiment tables, and then a tent for the sandwich makers. Judy had a team, and Audrey McGee had a team of workers, had 8 people making sandwiches. David Wood and Wesley McGee kept that warming box we bought, that cabinet we bought. That's the best thing we ever did to invest, because we made this. Daryl and Billy cooked the salt, all the meat, and Eric's doing the hot dogs. The women ate up making sandwiches, start making them up early. We put them in that warming cabinet, and they keep it stopped, and they move them over to the steam table. And we got all these people taking orders and running, got people doing drinks. It goes just like that. So we had a great day with that, but unfortunately, we didn't do as well financially this year because we've had some serious competition this year. We've had the Boy Scouts out there selling hot dogs before, and they didn't really hurt us. Last year, Lowe's Food Store, the grocery store folks, started coming out, and they're a for-profit business. Last year, they did ribs, didn't hurt us at all. This year, they had pulled pork. And our barbecue sandwich is our biggest draw. And along with that, we sell the hot dogs and hamburgers and the chips and all that. And they had 2 of their ladies out there dressed in their green shirts with Lowe's on it, and where the people come up from out of the park, what I call the park, to eat, they had them on each side of the fence, and they were over there, steering them over there. And at 11:30, 11:45, we had done nothing. But we went out, I went out and talked to them, complained about it, that, you know, it's not fair, you're out here directing these people. Somebody complained to Hart Square, they came, and I talked to the people, and they finally moved that away, and we did better. Judy Johnson went out there, and she competed with them. She steered a lot this way. So we, you know, we had a pretty good day, but it wasn't like what we did last year. I just like to report. This year, when I went home to count money last night, we had $10,913.60. Last year, that was about close to $14,000, so you see the difference there. A couple of days before Hart Square, I drew $3,300 out of the bank for seed money, for cash to give change back. Our expenses this year were $3,741.47 for expenses. So our profit this year, we made a profit. God will, Jesus will multiply it, as one of our people said. This year, our profit was $3,872.13, and that's $2,471.58 less profit than last year. So we felt like these people over there cost us most of that because they competed with us, what they were selling, and the way they were conducting the traffic over there. We did not know, we knew they were going to be out there, but we did not know that they were going to be selling the same thing. Basically, they had a barbecue pulled, they had a plate. They had a pulled barbecue, they had baked beans and slaw and a drink for $8. That was a good price, but they are backed by a business. And I talked to the people over there, and they had a manager from two different stores running the operation. And I asked, I said, well, what are y'all doing with your profit? Who you donate to? She said, well, we're a for-profit business. And I said, any of this going in your pocket? She said, well, I'm salaried, and at the end of the week, I get a percentage. So they were out there, you know, making money, and here we are, a church. You know, we gave $6,100 away last year for charitable contributions. This year, we're going to have to probably cut that in about half. If, you know, if we do Hart Square next year, we've got to have $7,000 left alone for seed money and expenses. And then, anything we make above that, we can donate like we did last year. So we're going to be okay, but we're just not going to have a big year like we did last year. We had cooked, and the reason I'm telling you this, because a lot of you won't be at the men's meeting, and a lot of you out here work, especially the ladies, they won't hear about this somewhere else. So, preacher, I'm sorry about the time here. But I just lost my train of thought. Okay, we cooked 11 and a half pans of barbecue, didn't we, Gary? Last Saturday, a week ago. Right. We had a little bit better than four of those pans, not even open by the steam tray. We had a bunch of sandwiches made up in the warming tables when the things tapered off. And a lot of those have been picked up, and a lot of our people out there working bought drinks, had a lot of drinks left over. Last year we sold out on drinks. We had three boxes of chips left. We never have chips left over. So it's three boxes of those. A whole bunch of hamburger buns and hot dog buns. And we bought six boxes of hot dogs, these big beef, 100% beef dogs. Had two whole boxes left over. So we're gonna be selling some things here, and hope that if you need some of these things, you can come and help us out. We got hot dog and hamburger buns. These are the big sesame seed buns, and we got the big hot dog buns. We pay their ballpark buns. We pay $3 a pack. We're gonna sell them for $1 a pack. Potato chips, 10 cents a bag, or whatever you want to do that. We have about 24 packs of the wieners left over. They're packaged in fives in a pack. We're gonna sell them for $2.50. That's about 50 cents a dog. That's about what we paid for. We got 20. Yeah, I think they've got 48 of them. I think there's 24 in a box. So if you need some good hot dogs, please help us out. There's some drinks left over. There are a few Sprites down there and a lot of diet drinks. Give us a dime a can. It would be good. We had a lot of chopped barbecue, but some of the guys have been putting it in a gallon bag. It's not a full gallon. You know, they didn't have a set of scales. So one bag might be a little bit more. But I think we sold just about all those. $15 a bag, if there's any left back there. 15 is a good deal. And we had a lot of slaw in those little condiment cups. We had it refrigerated, and you can get as many of those as you want. We had a lot of sandwiches left over, as I mentioned. We have back in the refrigerator, and I hope they've set it out. We got some barbecue sandwiches and some hamburgers that are wrapped in those nice folds. They've been in the refrigerator. They're free. They're good. I ate one of them last night. We heated in the microwave. So we'd like to, rather than throwing all that stuff away, if you could please use it, we'd be happy for you to get that for us. And again, just thank everybody that, like I said, drinks, water, money, time, desserts. Thank you so much. God bless you.
The month of October is... The month of October is selected as the month of the year that all churches show appreciation to their pastor. And we selected today. Pastor Dave, we appreciate you, and we thank you for your ministry here at Plattall United Methodist Church and the sermons that are filled with the Holy Spirit, and we thank you.
And thank all of you. Yeah, that kind of aggravates me about Hart Square. I mean, I hadn't been able to walk good for about the last 3 days, so I wasn't there. But as long as this church has been going out there, they ought to let commercial groups come in there. That just doesn't seem right. It is what it will be. But I personally, too, want to thank all of you that took part in it. I really miss not being there yesterday. And I enjoyed it. I guess I've been there 2 out of the last 4 times. And I've enjoyed it so much, the fellowship and all. Can I look at this now, or do I have to wait when I get home? Usually I take these home and let the missus have a hold of it, but this time I want to sit there. Oh, my goodness gracious. Well, thank you all so much. Thank you. You know, Cracker Barrel is one of my favorite places. Whoever chose that, chose wisely. Thank you all so much. It's a pleasure that having been appointed here. And I look forward to our time together. Anyone else have anything they'd like to share? Yes, ma'am. Corner table tomorrow at 11 o'clock. All right. Anyone else? It looks like we are ready to worship, so let us stand for the call.
Thank you.
Let us bow for our invocation. Almighty and eternal God, we have gathered on this Sunday morning to worship you, to praise you, to speak to you, to learn of you. Open our hearts and our minds, anoint us with the Holy Spirit. In Christ Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Our hymn of praise is number 3101 in the green book and on the screens. Barbara. Thank you, children. If our ushers will come forward, we'll have our morning offering.
Yeah.
Thank you, choir, so much. Beautiful. As it is every Sunday. Thank you all. A couple weeks ago, in my travels, I was asked, how should a Christian, what should a Christian do about Halloween? And I thought, well, I've always been under the assumption, if somebody's thinking about something, maybe somebody else is too. And they quoted to me scripture out of Deuteronomy. So this morning, for a few minutes, I'd like to read that scripture and talk about that for a few minutes. The scripture was the 18th chapter of Deuteronomy, the 9th through the 14th verses, which reads, "When you come into the land which the Lord your God is giving you, you shall not learn to follow the abomination of those nations. There shall not be found among you anyone who makes his son or his daughter pass through the fire, or one who practices witchcraft, or a soothsayer, or one who interprets omens, or a sorcerer, or one who conjures spells, or a medium, or a spiritualist, or one who calls up the dead. For all who do these things are an abomination to the Lord. And because of these abominations, the Lord your God drives them out before you. You shall be blameless before the Lord your God, for these nations which you will dispossess, listen to soothsayers and diviners, but as for you, the Lord your God has not appointed such for you." Let us pray. Almighty God, we thank you for the beautiful music, for the children's message, for all that we have heard, all that we have seen. Now may the word of my mouth, that says in my heart, be acceptable to you. May they be guided by you in Christ's holy name. Amen. The question was given to me, it's a pagan superstitious day. And what am I supposed to do with it? Well, yes, it is. It is. Our modern day of version of Halloween is far, far different from its original celebration. It was celebrated as a end of the harvest season. It was celebrated at the end of the warm weather and the coming of the dark, cold days of winter in Ireland and other parts of the British Isles. It was celebrated by the Celtics and the Druids. It was called Samhain, S-O-W-E-N is how it's pronounced. It was in 3 days filled with fear. They believed the veil between the living and the dead on those 3 days merged, and the spirits of the dead could walk upon the earth. They believed that what they had to do was create huge bonfires. Even for a while, they practiced sacrifices to their many gods for protection during the cold, dark days ahead. The customs spread through Europe. People would believe, they believed that those nights the spirits of the dead walked the streets. They would return to their homes to ward them off. They would take root vegetables, turnips, and gourds, anything they could find, and carve frightening faces in them, put a candle in them, put them on their doorsteps to scare off the dead. They also used it as an excuse to dress up and go out and do mischief, because they believed that if you were afraid of the dead, you put treats for them on your doorstep so they wouldn't trick you. When the church got a little bigger, well, actually it was Pope Gregory IV in the 9th century, he moved All Saints Day to the day after Halloween. Samhain was celebrated October 31st to November 2nd. So he plays November 1st, right in the middle of it, as All Saints Day. All Saints Day celebrations of the time began early in the morning and went all day in the churches. Of course, there was only one church at that time, the Church of Rome. The Pope did that because a lot of the good Christian Catholics were going out using it as an excuse to have a wild time, dressed up and carrying on. So the Pope said, I'll put a stop to that. I'll make them get up early in the morning and come to church. So that worked for a while. Then they found a new world. They came over then to Europe, to the new lands of America. Halloween here really didn't take off until the 19th century. Of course, there's still some that think of it as a dark day. There's still some that refuse to celebrate it. About every church I've had a trunk or treat or fall festival. I've had folks that refused to take part in it because they believed it was a day of the devil. Hollywood hasn't done anything to change their fears. Just think of all the horror movies that are on right now and will be all this coming week. A lot of our customs come from these old European traditions. Dressing up in costumes, going out trick-or-treating, decorating, lighting up the jack-o'-lanterns and what have you. But we all know that the dead don't walk the earth. We all know that really there's no such thing as superstition. We know because God, through His Son, the Christ, our Savior, tells us there's no such thing as that. So how does a Christian approach Halloween? We approach it as a day to have a little fun. It's nice to see children dress up, go trick-or-treating. Churches have fall festivals, they have trunk-or-treats. It's nice to stand there by the car and watch the little children come by all dressed up and give them candy. If you've never done that, go over to Wesley on Halloween and take part, or just come and enjoy the festivities. A Christian looks at Halloween about like we look upon anything else. It is a time to worship God, a time to praise God, a time to educate those who don't know about God, educate them about the love of the Christ. Educate them about what Halloween really is. Oh, you can get into what it used to be. The Druids were celebrating this well before, 1,000 years before the birth of Christ. It's not the dark day, not even in Europe, it's not the dark day that it was. When I grew up in Troy, New York, why, it was a night of mischief. You left the house, you had shaving cream in one pocket, you had bars of soap in your other pockets, you had matches to light the bonfires with in the middle of the street. In fact, the city spent the next 3 days repairing streets where people would throw anything that would burn in the middle of them and set fire to them, big bonfire. That's why if you had a porch, or as we call them, stoops, you went outside and made sure it was bolted down, nailed down, tied down, or you sat on it. Because chances are you would end up with a pile of ashes the next morning. Down here, I learned about toilet papering yards. Mm-hmm. Toilet papering yards, I know nobody here ever done anything like that, but we didn't do that in New York. But I did notice that the grocery stores would have huge displays of that stuff, usually at the end of an aisle. And I saw why. But Halloween is a night to, like most other nights, it's a night to enjoy. It's nice to go around and see some of the decorations. And I run across this. This kind of shocked me. People in the United States, they estimate, will spend $8 billion every Halloween, the month of October, on candy, on costumes, on decorations. It comes out to about $80 per household. Second only to Christmas. That surprised me. I didn't realize that. So how does a Christian approach Halloween? Approach it as what it is. It's just a cell, I won't call it a holiday, but it's just a night for the children. And it's for adults who want to act like children. It's a night to go out, and it's also a night to praise God. It's a night to go out, and if you see someone cowering in fear, tell them about the love of the Christ. You can take their fears away. If there's those that say, I don't celebrate it because it's the devil's day, educate them. Say, every day is the devil's day, because every day the devil walks the earth. So what makes that night special? It's special because of Hollywood, it's special because of its ancient lore. But you and I, we know there's nothing much to it all, don't we? We know that we can go out to events like Trunk or Treat, or take the children, grandchildren, if you're lucky enough to have them, go out trick-or-treating, door to door. Just be careful where you go, of course. The sad thing about Halloween is the adults, they get into something that it's not supposed to be. On November 1st, in the newspapers and on the news, we'll hear where people found razor blades, pins, nails, and other things, and candy and fruit. That's not what Halloween's all about. But some folks think they're happy about that. It's a fun, it's a joke. It's a deadly joke. A lot of drunk drivers on Halloween night for some reason, so the statistics say. They're usually children that are run down, crossing streets and all by these drivers, or drivers that just don't care, not looking out for them. It does have its dangers, but they're dangers of modernity and not anything from the ancient world. So how do we approach Halloween? Enjoy it. But be on the lookout for opportunities to praise God, to educate others about God, which is something that as Christians we're called to do every day anyway. So whatever you're going to do, October 31st, enjoy it. Whether it's go out to a costume party or trunk-or-treat or trick-or-treating, enjoy it. But just keep it in perspective. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our closing hymn is In the Faith We Sing, number 21-23.
Thank you.
whatever you do this Halloween, have a safe and well one. Have a happy one. I think the phrase is happy Halloween. Carve the pumpkin, do whatever you want to do, but enjoy it. And remember, use it as another opportunity to praise God. Go in peace, in love, and in comfort. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.